The Post-Truth World is a crime thriller film on Netflix. It's Taiwanese. I honestly didn't know much about this, but I wanted to check it out because the plot seemed a little bit intriguing. This is about Lu Liman. He is a sort of hotshot reporter back in the day, but many years later, he's sort of trying his own independent sort of online thing, part of the news network that he works for, and he's trying a new thing. But you know, he did a thing called Dissecting the Society, which was popular, but now he's kind of like floundering. He doesn't have many views. However, after doing an interview with an old man who does origami, he gets jumped by a murderer, accused murderer, a baseball genius who was accused of killing his girlfriend, Zhang, and Zhang basically escapes. It's like The Fugitive, but with a satirical sort of edge to it, with the whole social media aspect and live streaming. This movie starts off with that. It's very intriguing to begin. The parts of this thriller and the setup is better than the sum, because the movie does the foolish thing of putting all of its eggs into one basket with the big reveal of, you know, who killed the girlfriend. And when we get to it, it's rather underwhelming. And all the rest of the elements are kind of just like there too. You know, you've got your reporter who's kind of exploitative, who wants to do anything to get in the limelight. He's got a daughter. You've got our harried fugitive. There's a couple moments with some detectives that are, you know, trying to catch the guy, but it doesn't feel that thrilling. There's no big set pieces or anything. There's one decent chase and a couple other moments, but overall I think the real message of the movie gets sort of shafted by the end, because it's really weak. You know, the movie, you know, should be building up to something big and monumental. Instead, it winds down to a sort of, oh, that's it. And, you know, I can tell, like, maybe the budget wasn't that big on this movie, because there's like a car accident that's like cut to black and stuff like that. So maybe the budget of this thriller wasn't that big, but either way, you could do anything else. The reveal just felt really weak, and the acting's fine from everyone. I recognized the young girl. She was in American Girl. But overall, the movie just, you know, the message, you know, doesn't really bring it all the way home, to be honest. Movie's not that thrilling for a crime thriller. I think the third act kind of wiped away everything that it was building up. So I give The Post-Truth World a 4 out of 10.